Good morning, and we are live from Exmouth as we count down to this morning's historic total eclipse. The skies are clear here in the northwest. In fact, it is a beautiful day. We're sitting on a balmy 26 degrees, which the experts tell us is perfect weather for what's about to unfold here. In less than 30 minutes' time, well, it's actually already started, but we'll go through all of that as we unfold this morning. Well, we're here at the official viewing site for the eclipse in Exmouth. We're 30 kilometres out of town. This is the best view of the eclipse on the entire planet. This spot, which is the old Kaelas processing factory, is perfectly positioned to capture the total solar eclipse in its entirety. And in a moment, we'll have a look at exactly how the eclipse will unfold across the skies here in Exmouth. But first, Tracy Vo is at the town beach. It's been very popular this week. And Tracy, tell us, what's it like there?
It is quite magical here as well, Tomo. We've got plenty of families here. They're already looking through the solar glasses, obviously to be very sun safe. And as you mentioned, this eclipse is already sort of happening. They've encouraged us as well to have a look through these glasses and see what is happening as that moon passes the sun. So plenty of families here, a lot of photography enthusiasts as well, a lot of eclipse chasers. They're obviously having a lot of fun there. And probably a few hundred people have been lining up in the barbecue area here. We've also seen through the morning people trekking along the sand and sort of camping out there, building up their tents, setting up picnics and bringing down their eskies as well. So they're really here for the long ride, I suppose. And we've also been told that they would like to just all be quite quiet during that 62 seconds of totality. So the energy is really building here. You can also feel the temperature dropping a little bit as well. We were both told that, Tomo, that we would see a change in the conditions. So that's already starting here. A bit windy, but as you mentioned, clear skies all round.
Tracy, you just mentioned the temperature, and yes, we can feel the temperature just starting to fall as well. Start of totality is 11:27 this morning in the northwest for the total solar eclipse. Exmouth, the only town on the Australian mainland to see it in its entirety. And this is how it will look in Exmouth at its peak. It's pretty amazing. The entire sun covered by the moon. For a total of 62 seconds, the sudden darkness will impact the animal kingdom, and the temperature, as we already said, has started to drop. And in Perth, the sky will darken too, but about 10 minutes earlier. In the city, there'll be a partial solar eclipse with about 70% of the sun covered by the moon. And this will happen at around 11:20 a.m. It won't be completely dark, but you'll definitely notice the shadows. Okay, but this is why all the eyes are on Exmouth right now. This graphic shows the path of totality as the eclipse grazes the northwest coast of Australia. And you can see that red line. That's the line of totality as it goes right across Exmouth. It's the only town in the world that will lay directly in the path, which is very exciting for all of us here. And of course, we're being warned not to look directly at the sun during this eclipse, even in Perth. Now, you've probably seen eclipse glasses. That's the safest way to look at it. Or, of course, you can be watching it on Nine right now. And we're being encouraged to do it. I did it a short time ago and had a look. You can already see the moon going across the sun. We've got a host of experts to talk to, people who are right across everything from start to finish. And when the sky is completely dark, and it's going to look quite amazing here in the northwest for those 62 seconds of totality. Well, someone who's very excited joins us now, the Acting Premier, the Minister for Tourism, Roger Cook. I saw him going for an early morning run this morning. You must be excited. This is a great feeling.
Look, I am excited. We're all excited. This is the place to be on the globe today. And we're all here to experience a once-in-a-lifetime journey as the moon traces across the sun. And as you're saying, you can feel the temperature starting to drop. You can feel the excitement starting to build on the viewing platform, which we have just across the way.
Yeah, it's quite remarkable too. You actually gave me a pair of glasses when you came and said to have a look. And you can really see that movement start to happen. This has been a massive event. And this area has been remarkable, the transformation, hasn't it?
Yeah, this has been years in the planning. We've known this event's coming along for some time. We knew that the eyes of the globe would be on us, and that many tens of thousands of people would be travelling to this region to experience the eclipse. So we've done a lot of work. Over 14 government departments have been coordinating the effort, $22 million worth of investment. And of course, what we have just across the way here is the official viewing platform. couple of thousand people just over there with their telescopes, their excited families, because we are at the spot that we all want to be at this point in time anywhere in the world.
Just tell us a bit more about this spot and how you're able to construct what we'll see. And we're going to cross to Shirley Big shortly. It's quite an amazing story, isn't it?
It is. This is the old Kalis fishing compound. And the Kalis family very graciously donated that site to us for free. We've cleared it, hardened it to make sure that it can host the people. We've got chairs and tents out there for folk to get away from the sun. But as you say, it's getting cooler. Mm. And so we'll rehabilitate that area once we're finished. But it's a really exciting opportunity to be here at this spot, at this time, anywhere else in the world.
Infrastructure is crucial. There are long-term benefits too, aren't they? It's not just about today.
We've had three strategies around the total solar eclipse. Firstly, we wanted to make it safe. And that's why we've had emergency service workers here, main roads, all manner of public sector workers, over 100 in fact, to be here to just make sure that this is a safe experience. But we want it to be a great experience as well. And we've been working with the local tourism operators and small businesses to make sure that they get the sort of elevation in their product and their services that we need to cater for the masses of people who are here. And finally, we want it to be a legacy piece. We want people to remember Exmouth, and we want the Exmouth community to benefit for years to come. This is just 62 seconds of experience, but we want the memories to last a lifetime. And so we've put a lot of work in to make this worthwhile.
I've never been to an event like this. This is event tourism. Is this the model we should see going forward, do you think?
Well, I think people need to understand that people will travel around the world for this. We've got cruise ships anchored off the Gulf here with people on board experience it. We've got people flying in this morning, all people from all manner of life and around the world. You go over to the compound, it's like a village from the United Nations over there. There's people from everywhere around the world just coming to this point, at this point in time in Western Australia to experience the total solar eclipse.
As we approach totality, one last question. What are you looking forward to most?
Oh, look, I've got no idea what we're to expect. I'm told that you get a 360 sunset in the middle of the day, and that that you have this eerie silence that comes with the cool air that happens at the time. So I think it'll be quite a spiritual experience as well. Yeah. And to be able to share it with all these wonderful people, it's such a great journey to be on, with the departments that have been working together, the Shire of Exmouth, Onslow, Ashburton and Carnarvon, everyone working together to make this a great experience.
It's going to be fantastic. Acting Premier Roger Cook, thank you.
Thanks for your time.
All right, let's go to Shirley Biggs. She's over in the viewing platform. Roger just mentioned that. And the weather conditions look absolutely perfect for a celestial event. Sherry, what's it like over there?
Well, Tomo, it was a bit of a nervous wait last night and this morning to see what the skies would do. But if you were up early enough, you would have captured this incredible sunrise over Town Beach here in Exmouth. Strange to think now that in around 20 minutes, that sun will be completely eclipsed. It was touch and go there for a while, though. Driving into the viewing site this morning, there has been a bit of cloud about, but thankfully it looks like it will remain east of us, and it has cleared off from the site. Winds have dropped off now as well, though. It's currently around 26 degrees here in Exmouth, but during totality, without the warmth of the sun, that apparent temperature could drop by 5 or even 10 degrees. Now, for those watching in Perth, beautiful, mostly clear skies as well, around 23 degrees, but hopefully you have an extra layer with you because you'll also get that big drop in temperature. Now, Tomo, it is so close now. Like many people here, it is my first eclipse, so I'm very much looking forward to it. I've got my glasses ready to go.
So have I, and I'm very excited as well, Sherry. Thank you. And this is how we'll be showing you today's eclipse during this live broadcast. As we get closer to totality, we'll bring it up on the bottom right of your screen, then we'll take it full screen about 11:27 a.m. when the moon obscures the sun, turning day into night for a total solar eclipse. So many experts we're going to talk to today, and Matt Woods from the Perth Observatory. Matt, great to see you. I know this is a very exciting time for you. How are you feeling?
Yeah, massive relief. All the testing went really well. The live stream's working, which is fantastic considering we're in such a remote place. So yeah, just extremely happy that I'm here. And you can actually notice it's starting to get a little bit cooler. You don't have that radiant heat hitting from the sun.
Yeah. For everybody at home, just tell us about a total eclipse. What actually is it?
So what's actually happening is the moon is moving in front of the Earth. And so it just happens to be that it's at the right time at the right place that it's going to block the sun completely. And that's because even though the moon is 400 times smaller than the sun, it's 400 times closer to us. So it's the only planet and moon that actually allows you to do this and be actually able to see the corona of the sun, the outer shadow.
The time frame is remarkable. How do you know that? How do we know what time it's going to come and across this path?
Well, that's the thing. It normally takes about 18 months if we'll get an eclipse, a solar eclipse, and we'll also get a lunar eclipse either side about 2 weeks before. So we've actually got a preumbra eclipse in early May, which you get a slight darkening of the moon. But we've been able to work out since ancient times using mathematics when these eclipses are going to happen.
Totality, 62 seconds. What's that going to be like?
Oh, madhouse. pulling off solar filters, making sure the cameras are taking the right photos. So, yeah.
How dark will it get?
It's going to get dark. This is my first total solar eclipse. So, yeah, this is something I'm really looking forward to.
And we're hearing it's going to affect the animals, the birds, all sorts of things.
Yeah. And I'm just looking forward to seeing, like, how cold it gets as well, how dark it gets. I'll probably try and jump out from my seat and look behind me as the shadow comes racing up towards us.
The shadow which will come from the southwest, and we will see that, and you can see on your screens as well just where the moon is at in front of the sun. You're live streaming to a big audience.
Yeah, so at the moment I think 34,000 just on time and date alone, but that feed's going out to all sorts of places, even Channel 9.
So. All right, and around the world as well, which
yeah.
is fantastic.
Yep.
Have a great eclipse, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, yep, and thanks Sherry for getting good weather for us today.
It's perfect, isn't it?
Yes, so we'll have to find some wood to knock on.
Okay. Matt Woods, please enjoy today, and you've done so much work and good luck with everything.
Thanks very much.
Good on you. Matt Woods there from the Perth Observatory. One of his assistants has just come over and said you need to come now. We're going to take a short break and then we'll be coming back for what is a truly historic event right here in Exmouth. Don't go away.